Hey guys, this is your host Kunjan D. Shinde. I welcome you all to my classes. Today's topic is realization of 8:1 mux per Verilog STL lab 15 ESL 58 as per VTU syllabus. So let us begin with the block diagram. A multiplexer or mux has 2n inputs, n select line and 1 output. It is a combinational logic circuit which selects any one of the 2n inputs and connect it to the our single output. The selection of the input is based on the select lines which are of n inputs. Multiplexer is also known as a data selector or many to one logic. So let us look into now the truth table of this 8:1 mux. As a 8:1 mux has 8 inputs, 3 select lines and 1 output as Y. The select lines are indicated with the key variable as S and the inputs as I. So when the input combination of the select line is 000, I of 0 input is connected to the output Y. Whatever the value I of 0 holds, the output Y is getting updated with that value. Similarly, for rest of the combination, if the input line is 100, in the sense of select line is 100, so we have I4 connected to the output Y. Irrespective of the changes in other inputs, output will not be affected. If I4 changes from 0 to 1 or 1 to 0, the output is going to be updated. And hence we have the truth table for 8:1 mux. Figure shows the logic diagram of 8:1 mux, which is designed using NOT gates, AND gates and OR gate as indicated in the figure here. So based on a particular combination, a AND gate is enabled and that is connected to a OR gate. At a given point in time, only one of the input is connected to the output and the selection of the input is based on the select lines. This multiplexer can be implemented using various style of modeling in Verilog STL. Now data flow modeling for 8:1 mux. Here expression is considered and output equation for Y is been written. So if I0 is to be selected, so it will be the ultimate result of S2, S1 and S0 complementary versions of these inputs. Similarly for rest of the inputs, and the keywords are highlighted here. We can see with the implementation of this code, you can verify the function of 8:1 mux. Data flow modeling is not effective way to write program for 8:1 mux, as the expression or the Boolean equation becomes lengthier for higher order of the mux. So let us move into behavioral style of modeling. So in this behavioral style of modeling, we can make use of a case statement to implement this logic. Here the always block is sensitive to S or I, where S is the select line and I is the input. I is a 7 down to 0 vector and S is 2 down to 0 vector, which is of 3 bits and I is of 8 bits. So this case statement is executed when the case is going to a particular condition, either S, based on S values, the output Y is updated to either I0, I1 or the other input still I7. As all the various possible combinations for S variable is covered here, we need not make use of a default statement. So we are terminating with the end case and end module. This completes the behavioral code. Let us simulate this one and verify the functionality. Behavioral coding is one of the best way to code a circuitry where it has many inputs and outputs to be observed. So now let us look into structural style of modeling. So here in structural style, we define the circuitry or digital circuit in the form of logic gates that are being used to implement this particular logic. So as we know, 8:1 mux utilizes NOT gate, AND gate and OR gate, so which are been written in this particular way. So the intermediate connection between the gates are considered as temporary connections as wires. Say for connection between the NOT gate from complementary versions of select lines, we are considering it as a S0 bar, S1 bar and S2 bar, and hence on so forth for rest of the signals. And a temporary signal T has been declared here to give the outputs of a AND gate. So this implements the structural style coding for 8:1 mux. Hey guys, like and share this video with your friends and colleagues. If you like the video, give us a thumbs up and let me know what you think about the video in the comments below. Subscribe to my channel for more updates. Now let us look into the simulations for these coding. For simulation, I will be making use of a Xilinx ISC software 9.1i version. So with this tool, we'll be proceeding. Go to file, click on new project, give the file name, click on next. Select the family type for FPGA, programming language as Verilog STL, click on next. Click on new source, select Verilog module, then give a file name, click on next, next, finish, yes, next, next, finish. Now let us copy paste the code that we have written earlier and we'll perform check syntax. Once you have copied, save, go to synthesis, then double click on check syntax. Once the check syntax process completes, we can go for simulation. As you can see, there are no errors. So we'll go for simulation. Right click on the source file, new source, select a test bench waveform module, then give the file name, click on next, finish. After this phase, click on finish. Now the simulation window will appear. Elaborate S input and I inputs. Now for S inputs, we'll be giving in the form of all the combinations as 0 to 7. So we'll be moving on with this one. So let us apply the inputs and see. Now start applying the inputs with some random pattern. So for the time being, I will be selecting 1 for some set of combination and 0 for rest of the set so that I can verify the functionality, which line is getting selected at the output. So randomly we can apply this. It's not any mandatory. We have to apply in this particular way only. Once completed with the test inputs, save it. Then we go to behavioral simulation. Check the file, select the file. Elaborate Xilinx IAC, double click on simulate behavioral model. Now you can see the simulation results. Elaborate the S inputs and I inputs. Now we can verify the functionality. Click on 000. For this one, I of 0 is 1 and hence the output is 1 for the given set of combinations. Next, moving on to the next set, 001, we have I of 1 is 0, hence the output is 0. Next input is 010. For this, I of 2 is 1 and hence the output is 1. You can verify the same functionality for rest of the other combinations. Now looking at the scenario 100, in this one I4 is also 1 and the output is 1. So by this we can say the functionality of 8:1 MUX has been verified. Similarly, we'll copy paste the behavioral code, we'll perform the same sort of process to simulate and verify its functionality. You can see the simulation results are same. Similarly, we'll copy paste the program for a structural code. We'll verify its functionality with the same process. And now you can see the simulation results are the same. By this, we can say Verilog STL can be used to verify the functionality of 8:1 MUX. You all can use the following code to verify the functionality. Hey guys, this is your host Kunjan D. Shinde. I thank you all for your patience.